It was a daunting prospect for me because I know obviously how important Peter James is to Brighton. It's his hometown. People have read his books, they know his work. But it was wonderful. I kind of feel like it's a bit of a homecoming maybe for Roy Grace. And thoroughly enjoyed the performance tonight. Really, really enjoyed it.
I hammed it up for the rest of the night.
Do you know, it's so weird because I'm actually backstage when he's on stage, you know, and I'm still laughing. Every time actually he says something and I'm laughing with the audience, you know, at the same time. I'm thinking, how many times actually I've heard it? But I still found it funny.
I mean, it's a wonderful story. And we thought it was a story that people could relate to because although it's about a couple murdering each other, it is also about, you know, a marriage and relationships. And indeed, we see that in the audience wherever we go. People kind of nudging each other going, oh, that's a bit like you, when, you know, the snoring that annoys them or whatever it is that drives this couple mad with each other in the play. And so we thought that was one of the things that attracted us to this. It was a play that people could really relate to.
The way police officers deal with it is their own sort of gallows humour, I think they call it, just to try and ease the tension a little bit, because they can be very difficult cases and you just need to sort of lighten it a little bit, but whilst respecting what you're doing. So, and I think that definitely shows on the play.
It's been an amazing night here at the Theatre Royal in Brighton. Peter James bringing it all back home, bringing the perfect murder to Brighton, making an amazing speech from the stage at the end. A lot of people giving money to the police charities. It's been a fantastic night.
The Roy's Grace novel has to be set in Brighton. It has to be set in Brighton.